Hi, I'm Chris Katulka with the Friends of Israel Gospel Ministry, and before we get to this week's Eye on the Middle East, I'd like to share an urgent need with you. As you may know, I host the Friends of Israel Today radio program, and every week we have the privilege of providing listeners with biblical content on the air and through our podcast. But what you may not know is that our program is supported by generous donors and listeners and friends just like you. Through the month of November, we need your help. Can you help us raise $25,000 this month to take the gospel to the ends of the earth? The world is desperate for biblical truth about Israel and the Messiah. So with your financial gift, right now, you can help keep the Friends of Israel Today's trustworthy, uncompromising biblical teaching in the ears and hearts of those who need to hear. Would you make a gift before November ends? Go to foi.org/radio support to make your meaningful gift today. Hi, everyone. I'm Chris Katulka with the Friends of Israel Gospel Ministry, and this is an Eye on the Middle East. There are conflicting reports coming out of Israel claiming that Iran's supreme leader, Ali Khamenei, has gone into a coma. According to Ynet News, Tehran has already secretly chosen Mojtaba Khamenei, the second son of Iran's supreme leader, to be the new Iranian leader. While the Times of Israel reports that Iran recently published photographs of Khamenei, claiming he's still alive and leading. This after Iran launched an attack on Israel last month. Reports say that Mojtaba could take over even before his father's death, if this is true. This could have ramifications for Iran given the situation in Israel today with Hamas and Hezbollah. Well, here's my take. We'll have to wait and see whether the reports about the 85-year-old Ayatollah are true. If they are, this is once again more evidence that you don't mess with Israel. The prophet Zechariah reminds us in Zechariah 2:8, "For whoever touches you, Israel, touches the apple of God's eye."